Assalamu alaikum and very good morning. I'm glad to be here again. Thank you for the invitation to share such an important topic. I tried my best to, enrich the topic. So I added something which we call it why article get rejected, because to know how to deal with the reviewer comments and how to interact, we have to understand why the articles get rejected, because this is the most annoying part the part that basically dictates our response and our reaction after all. So we start from the completion of the research. Once we complete the research, then we prepared the manuscript. We target particular journal. This is done by the authors. So after this, we start to communicate the manuscript through the journal submission system by the corresponding author. So once it is received by the editor, so what would happen is there is two possibilities. Normally we like have the editor assign reviewers to look at the paper and all this, but nowadays they can just go for rejection without any review, and that is very frequent nowadays because journals are trying to differentiate themselves. Those journals classified as tier 1 or Q1 journals, they are trying to they receive so many publications, so many submissions. So they're trying to, maintain the quality, and, they have very high rejection rate. So it means once you submit, instead of the editor just processing the article for revision process, it's just reject at, and without, further review, just rejection. And we will detail a little why this happened actually. So normally, this is the new point here. Most of the journals, they have what you call it journal manager. The journal manager will basically receive the paper and do the processing, the checking from format and all its point of view. Then it will be passed to the reviewer. So normally we don't deal nowadays with with the editors directly. And most of the time, like Elsevier, for example, they have offices in India. So your paper will just go to India for some verification in terms of format and adherence to the the journal requirement for submission and so on before it is sent to the editor who might be in UK or in Germany or in US or something like this. So the normal way is the editor will assign the reviewers. Then based on this, the reviewers will decide, okay, reject or accept. And when accept, they have different categories. So reject, normally we will go back and do some action, might be referring to the research or going and looking at what need to be done. But when it's a revision, they have, minor revision, accept. This one, they call it accept with minor revision, accept with major revision. Or sometime they have what you call it, a case, we call it resubmit. Resubmit means, the article require overall. So it's not something that is beyond the measure when they feel the topic is interesting, but the way the article is presented is just, and this is least likely to happen nowadays. Most of the journals, they just go straight to rejection, or we just give you, a minor or major correction in this case. And after this, we do the correction, then we do the resubmission, then paper goes back to reviewers, and either rejection or acceptance, then it goes after this for processing for publication. After this, what actually the editor will be looking for any particular paper once submitted? So number one, the main issue is suitability, and here there is misunderstanding or misconception, because most of the time you think the journal, but it's like, okay, in the name sound, in the field, or some of you guys might or girls might go to, website which select the journal for you based on the keywords and, abstract. There is a risk there, because the first thing is you have to understand the scope. Because the first thing that the journal will do initial screening. Okay, does the topic, of the article fit the journal, or might be it's suitable for a sister journal? And you can see some of the journals will respond to you that this is more specialized topic and you should go for other journal. They may suggest you other journal belong to the same publisher, for example. The type and the format. Okay, for example, you are submitting what? You are submitting a review article, or you are submitting a short communication, or you're submitting a full article, or you are submitting an article for a special issue. So in this particular case, let's say you are trying to submit a short communication which is not fit to be a short communication. They will ask you to better submit a full article if they like the topic, for example. So the first one will be the suitability, which is based on, screening, right? And also the serious one that they look at, the clear plagiarism and the self-plagiarism, which is basically they introduced recently after they just realized that some authors, they just, copy paste from some previous publication, they add to their own, articles. For example, like when you report methodology, so you are basically, cut and paste from the previous methodology again, even though that methodology is published, so it should be written in a less intense manner, okay? Sometimes we have to write intensively because, journal is scope, it's not covering, for example, that special method you are using. So it depends. So in this particular case, this is the most difficult part, actually, for me and for everybody, because they use a software. It's not the Turnitin. We normally run the Turnitin, but they have more tighter, softwares, which is basically count. Even in my case, I submitted one article. Then I get this message that we have 24%, self-plagiarism. I look at the self-plagiarism is all three words. And like these three words or two words are basically technical expression, which I coined myself. It's my specialty in my research. So when I say degree of grafting or effect of radiation dose, those are terminologies that keep coming all the time. But the editor refused to, he just captured this and just reject the paper in the basis that self-plagiarism, 24%. The second point where the editor will look at the significance, and this is the most crucial part. This is the killer part for all of us. What they want to know, after the preliminary check, you pass through, then they will look at the second point. Is it novel enough? The novelty of the work. Differences from prior art or the previous work. And this you have to make very clear in the introduction before you set the objective. You have to identify the research gap. Okay, so the importance of this particular article to the researchers in the field and to the readers of the journal. Okay, and this is basically the most important hurdle. Why? Because the novelty and all this, they have different degrees. From your point of view, if you work with nanoparticle, if you move from, let's say, nano silver to gold nanoparticle, instead of using silver nanoparticle, you use gold nanoparticle in one application. It just change the metal, or from zirconium oxide, for example, to alumina. Okay, then you think this is a contribution, but the editor might think otherwise, and this is not really a level of contribution, because basically people working with composite, you can add zirconia, you can add silica, you can add anything. The concept of having nano composite is not new. This why the level of novelty will always vary, and the journals will decide based on the significance of the work in this particular case, the way the editor see, because very simple, the editor is the one who is going to decide on that. And their rationale for this is they are saying, sorry guys, we have a limited space for publication, so we have to prioritize, whatever consider priority. So that's where we will focus. So again, here, novelty, uniqueness, originality, we will touch later on
cover
this.
Later
he will look at the title, he will look at the conclusion section. He will look at the abstract, the keywords, literature references, and the visual information. If you look at this, this is exactly where sometimes some mistakes happen. Like can you imagine you have a problem, English problem with the title, Can you imagine the impression? You know, sometimes we, and because we deal with scientific terminology, sometimes, you know, we don't pay attention too much. You know, people use the, you know, definite articles in the title. They add a. They, you know, is the article really, you know, the title need to have that? Sometimes we, you know, because of this, what do you call it, hyphenated adjectives, we make some mistake. You know, the title from the beginning, you see the title is just mistake, immediate. So impression is not good. The cover letter, when the cover letter basically is just, we normally have a, like a template, you know, dear editor, I would like to submit an article entitled blah, 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 blah for consideration on one of the future issues of your journal, like something like that. But basically, it's not enough. We have to basically furnish, you know, what is the problem and how the problem was dealt with and the major findings and how this will be appealing to the reader of the journal. Then we have to declare if no conflict of interest and, you know, that article submits solely to this particular journal. There are some few things we have to add. Some journals actually, like, for example, Journal of Applied Polymer Science, they give you, you know, questions, a number of questions you have to answer in the cover letter. So this is basically keywords, you know, conclusion, abstract. Imagine if you make a mistake in the abstract. Imagine if you make a mistake in the conclusion. This is where the editor will scan through. He cannot read all the articles in details, but he will scan through, and based on the attractiveness, he will dive more in the article and make a quick decision, reject this paper because it's not worthy. It's full of a lot of mistakes, right? Keywords. And now most of the students, I just realized, they just pick up keywords from previous papers. You know, it's like other people, you know, you read, you know, so you can imagine if you pick up the same keywords, what will happen when the guy will just search, you know, using the browser. You've just put these keywords and he will get tons of articles and he will feel that your article read not really, you know, it's covered in many instances and really, you know, nothing unique there. So that's why, you know, we you know, we try to, you know, coin, I use the term coin. We try to coin, what do you call it, the best keywords for every article of our article carefully. You know, you have to consult about this. Why you can imagine this is will be, you know, the where somebody search, this is where the article will appear. So from the reviewer, from the editor point of view, if this is like, you know, very common topic, so it means the originality is not really very high in this particular case. Now come to this one. What is the reason for editor immediate rejection for the submission? Right? Okay, number one, articles fall outside the scope of the journal. Okay, this is frequently happened because what? We don't understand the scope of that particular journal. So we think, for example, you know, I personally, there is a journal called Functional Polymers. Every time I submit, it gets rejected. Then I thought, you know, all the while, I thought I understand the scope and the mentality of the editor. But actually, after discussion with some colleagues, and I just realized that this particular group of editor, you have editor-in-chief and few. And these people are basically conservative kind of editors. They just, you know, they are not really keen to deal with certain topics. You know, functional polymer cover everything basically. So they are interested in things which as nano involvement and, you know, like things that they consider new. They are not looking for conventional polymeric material. Okay, they are looking for something special, you know. So if that's the mentality, so if you are like, my paper is conventional, so I don't have to go and waste my time, you know, because the, you know, that's the mentality, their mentality. Okay, so we have to understand. So these people immediately, they give you immediate rejection. I have one, you know, I enjoyed having one rejection from this particular journal. And that particular paper, you know, was accepted in a better journal, environmental chemical engineering journal. I was submitting paper about, you know, adsorbent for, you know, boron removal and wastewater treatment, right? It was just straight rejected, right? So rejected means without revision. Same paper, I took it, I submitted to another journal, which is environmental chemical engineering journal. okay, which is basically more close to chemical engineering, you know, it was accepted. And basically, this journal is higher impact factor than the other one. So again, it's, you know, we have to look at the scope, and we look at our article published frequently in this kind of journal, or what kind of article published there. So I advise you, after you read the scope, you know, flip through, go through, you know, few issues. You see what's going on. What's the journal mean? You know, don't look at the paper published 10 years ago, because most of the students, yeah, I found this journal, the article published 10 years ago, you know, of 7-8 years ago. The journal every year they change, you know, they keep changing, right? So it doesn't mean it is published 10 years ago. It doesn't mean it's a suitable right now for this kind of publication. So you have to understand that. Another one, you know, the article, the topic is, you know, it's just like some topics are not really interesting. And I have gone through this a few times where the editor sending me an article to review, and I don't know what this topic all about. I don't understand anything from that particular article. Somebody is talking about particular metal, that's metal extracted from a mine. You know, we when you read, you feel, what is this actually? So if you don't catch the interest of the editor for one reason or another, when you look at, I think I mentioned in the previous slide, the points that catch the eye of the editor, he wouldn't be, you know, allowing you to go for further revision. The article will not go for reviewing process. Right. I brought this figure again from the previous presentation, which shows, you know, this is like, you know, when you enter, when you submit your article, it's like the car in the top, and it become like this after basically the peer review. It means you will go through everything. They will try to, you know, try to put here, there, you know, change this, change that, add here, add there. That is basically sometime, you know, why I put this, because sometimes we don't agree with the reviewer. We see our paper should be like this, but the reviewer wants like this. So what are you supposed to do? If you oppose without any valid reason, the paper will be rejected. Sometimes we do it under the pressure, but just, you know, but the line between this and, you know, you shouldn't agree on everything, you know. I have one instance where somebody submitted the article, and every remark he respond, thank you for the editor for this kind of remark. Then he tried to, you know, actually some of this you shouldn't entertain, actually, because he might not be reading the article properly. You know, some of these people, they read the article in not just 1 hour and make remarks. So you have to be standing on a solid ground and make a rebuttal, make a defense like a lawyer with, you know, valid, you know, tools and, you know, and data and things like this in your hand. So it does not mean you have to agree on everything. Of course, obvious things, things which have we forgotten, things which improve the work, we definitely will follow. But it will be something like this, you know, 7 big sense. This is something interesting, you know. Data manipulation is one of the falsification of one of the big things. Duplicate manuscripts, okay, or multiple submission, redundant publication. Multiple submission means you submit the same article, okay, you know, to different journals, or basically, you know, you twist the paper, you know, and put it in a, you know, nowadays with the internet. You know, if you put the paper in a conference and you put all the details, it's difficult to publish in a journal. So you have to be careful, you know, otherwise it's considered redundant publication. Plagiarism, author conflict of interest, if this is serious also, because sometimes data is related to projects and the funder does not allow you to publish. So you have to be careful in if you proceed with this. I stop here. This is the end of the part one, which I felt is so significant to understand basically why articles get rejected, to understand what's your, you know, reaction or what you're supposed to do after the article get rejected. Thank you very much.